Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss on the topic IT infrastructure and emerging technologies. Let us discuss the learning outcome on this topic. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe stages, technology drivers and components of IT infrastructure. First of all, we'll discuss IT infrastructure. What is IT infrastructure? Infrastructure is made up of all the devices, all the softwares, all the hardwares which is required to run for the enterprise systems, to run for the business systems. So we define IT infrastructure as a set of physical devices and software required to operate enterprise, because enterprise is a very big organizations where these infrastructures are required to run smoothly their businesses. So some infrastructures are composed of physical devices and as well as softwares which is required to their own business. These infrastructures have a set of firm-wide services including computing platforms which provides computing services. Then they have telecommunication services which provide communication between customers, between dealers and between enterprises. Then they have data management services where they are managing a data centrally around the enterprise. Then application software services which are required to compute the various tasks in the enterprises. Then physical facilities management services which is required to run for the environmental management which is required in the enterprises. And the most important thing is IT management, standards, education, research and development services. These are the important factors which is required to operate our enterprise business. This is a diagram of IT infrastructures where it defines all the IT services and infrastructure which composed of IT strategy, business strategy and information technology. Because IT strategy and infrastructures which is composed of all these factors, where these factors are interfacing with each other around the globe, around the enterprises or around the different type of businesses which is required to run the enterprise. In these infrastructures, the peoples which are involved as a customer services, then supplier services as well as the knowledge enterprises, where these three factors are involved centrally in the IT infrastructures. These are very important for enterprises to run their business smoothly. What are the different eras, or we can say evolution, for IT infrastructure? Firstly, some few computers which are connected to the system, there is no LAN. Only three or four systems are connected to the computers where all the things are stored and managed equally. Now different evolution comes into the market as some systems are connected in the network environment where the centrally server acts as a enterprise server where all the business tasks are performed. Then all the systems, all the services are connected to the internet where the people can share their businesses, their tasks, their other works around the world through the internet. And next is the things which are connected to the internet are operated smoothly to run their infrastructures. These evolutions are increasing day by day to run the enterprises smoothly. So eras in infrastructure evolution is very important nowadays. What kind of evolutions of IT infrastructures? We here mention general purpose mainframe and mini computers era which were present from 1959 to the present. Some companies, some enterprises, they are using mainframe. Some small scale companies, they are using the mini computers. Then personal computers are started from the 1981 to the current, where all the individual person or the business persons are use these personal computers for their enterprises. Then the picture comes in the client server infrastructure, where all the clients are connected to the server which is required for the business. Then enterprise internet computing era, here all the devices are connected to the internet for their enterprise business. These were present from 1992 to the current year. Next evolution comes under the cloud computing, where different kind of data are stored on the cloud. This comes in the year 2000 to the present. Now all the enterprises are currently running in the business. So these are the evolutions of IT infrastructure increases day by day. Now the next evolution comes under the client server network, which are multi-tiered, or we can say it is entire environment, where the clients are directly connected to the internet and web server, application server and main data servers, which are also connected to the internet, where client can send their data to the internet, to the data server. Again, the client can receive the updated data from the data server to the internet and to the client. These multi-tiered client server networks are very useful for the enterprises where a large number of data are processing. So that's why most of the companies, most of the organization, enterprises utilizes this multi-tiered client server network for their smooth business. So that's why multi-tiered client server networks are very important in the enterprise. Technology drivers of infrastructure's evolutions. What are the different laws which we apply for driving the infrastructure evolution? In the first one is Moore's law, where Moore's law, the microprocessing power are checked, means where some powers are double every year, means the data are processing through the processors increasingly. So the new technology comes under the nanotechnology, which may shrink size of transistor to width of several atoms. Previously, these transistors were used to have some large amount of data, but because of nanotechnology, we can shrink the size of transistors to width of several atoms. Then some contrary factors which we consider as heat dissipation, which were need to reduce the processing power, where power consumption concerns are very important. Second is law of mass digital storage, where the amount of data being stored each year which doubles when the enterprise stores the data centrally on the server. In that case, law of mass digital storage are considered to the amount of data storing. This is a diagram in the first figure, which we analyzes the technology drivers of infrastructure evolution year wise. So these in the first figure, they are showing the increasingly the microprocessing power of data, which comes under the Moore's law. In the second figure, the technology drivers are also increasing as per the processing powers are increased. New technology eras are comes into the picture in the second figure. Third figure, some nanotechnologies are used to process the data in a low width manner. So this is shown in the third figure, that is A, B and C. In the C figure, there are large amount of data. In the B figure, there are some data reduced, and in the A figure, again some data are reduced because of Moore's law and law of mass storage. So these infrastructures evolution shown in the form of graph. So in first diagram, the graph are increased as per the hard drives are utilizing to store the data year wise. And the second diagram also, where the data are processing as per the capacity required to store on the data server. So these evolutions are increased day by day nowadays. What are the components which we use in infrastructure? First one is computer hardware platform, second OS platform, third enterprise software applications, then data management and storage, network or telecommunications platform, internet platform and consulting system intelligence services. These are all seven infrastructure components which are required to run the enterprise systems. After discussing so many things, we have some questions. List each of the eras in IT infrastructure evolution. Think for a while on this question and give the answer. Okay, the first answer is general purpose mainframe and mini computer era. Second, personal computer era. Third, client server era. Fourth, enterprise internet computing era. Cloud computing era. These are all the required. Next is we see the ecosystem for infrastructures. These are all the seven types of ecosystems which is required for run the enterprise systems, where all the computer devices, hardware devices, physical devices, IT infrastructure, human powers, everything are considered in the IT infrastructure enterprises. So these ecosystems are built together to run the enterprise system. So that's why infrastructure ecosystems are very, very important for the newly generated enterprise system in the information systems. These are the references for this topic. Thank you.